Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rudder Lessons. Welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate your time and your viewership. It means a lot to me. And in today's episode, we're going to be going over 10 fragrances that I will never stop recommending. And this is part two, so make sure to stay tuned. Now, before I begin this video of 10 fragrances that I will never stop recommending, and of course, this is a part two because I have done a part one, I'm gonna leave a card to it up here. I do wanna mention that if you are a fan of these types of videos, if you like top 10s, reviews, giveaways, unboxings, anything that has to do with fragrances, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell icon. This way, whenever I do put out these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. And I also want to mention that I believe this is an idea or a tag video that was started by George Atkinson from the YouTube channel The Fragrance Apprentice. I'm going to leave his information down below, so definitely make sure to subscribe to him and check him out. I was not tagged to do this video, but I find it to be a pretty cool idea, hence the reason why I'm doing a part two. And I also want to mention that this video is being shot in collaboration with FragranceUSA.com. If you are interested in sampling or purchasing any of the fragrances in this video, you may do so at FragranceUSA.com. I'm going to leave their information down below. Definitely make sure to check them out. They have really good prices on hard-to-find designer and niche fragrances. Don't take my word for it. Go and check them out, and you'll see just how inexpensive and affordable their products are. So with that being said, these are 10 fragrances that I have recommended to people so much throughout the years. Some of these are more recent releases, and so maybe for a couple of them, I've only been recommending them for the past year or so, but some of these have been around for a long time. One fragrance in particular has been around for 11 years now, and that's actually the one in the number 10 spot. But you know, this list is much different than if I were to get in front of the camera and make a video on my top 10 favorites of all time. Because my nose is kind of geared towards the strange, and I do like fragrances that are a little bit more avant-garde and quirky, and I don't mind wearing fragrances that are a little bit on the darker side with notes of benzoin and birch tar and cade oil and oak moss. And you know, there are a lot of ingredients out there that don't necessarily smell mass marketed or mass appealing, for lack of a better phrase, but there's just something about all 10 of these fragrances that I always have a very easy time recommending, and I recommend them with ease. So with that being said, let's just go ahead and start the list. The number 10 on my list is, for obvious reasons, Creed Aventus. Now, the reason I put this in the number 10 spot is because I know it's being spoken about interminably on YouTube. And this is a fragrance that I now own many, many, many bottles of. I've used up many bottles of this fragrance. And I know what a lot of people home are probably thinking, Steven, you have Club de Nuit Intent for men. There is Mont Blanc Explorer. There's L'Aventure by Al Haramein. Why are you recommending Aventus, which is so expensive, when you could be recommending these more inexpensive designer clones, if you will? And my answer for that is because Creed uses captive ingredients in their fragrances, which means that there are certain ingredients and certain molecules that only they have the license to use. So nobody else can use them. So although there are a lot of clones on the market, they will never smell 100% similar to Creed Aventus. And if you do have a pretty considerable budget, given you know what you're willing to spend on fragrances, and you really want the cream of the crop, if you will, you know, Creed Aventus did not become so popular because it sucks. It became so popular because it's widely loved and admired, and many people own it. So much so that people make Facebook groups out of it and t-shirts and wedding cakes, guilty as charged. But anyway, Creed Aventus, awesome fragrance. I'm personally a fan. The next fragrance that I recommend to people who are interested in getting something a little bit darker, they don't perhaps want something that's very bright and airy and citrusy. This one by Mancera is called Red Tobacco. Now, I know this one has been around for a few years now, so this one is going to give you that aromatic presence in the heart with the tobacco, but it also gives you this undercurrent of vanilla that I think is a really nice juxtaposition to the tobacco. It does have a tendency of coming across a little bit aggressive and a little bit spicy as well, but I think if you are a fan of this type of a fragrance, and if you're a fan of this genre, this one will really hit the nail on the head for you. So this one is not as sweet as Tobacco Vanille by Tom Ford, but this one is a little bit more aggressive, but it's definitely mysterious and it's very easy to pull off. So I definitely recommend Red Tobacco by Mancera if you're in the market for something that's a little bit dark. Speaking of tobacco, the next fragrance on this list is also a tobacco-based fragrance, but this one is sweeter and it also has notes of coconut and rum. It's spicy, it's a little smoky, it's balsamic, it's sweet, it's such an amazing fragrance. And this one by the company Nishane is a 2016 release. It's been around for 5 years now. This one is called Fan Your Flames. Now the closest comparison that I could make to this one is Parfum de la Nuit 2 by Roja Parfum. If I'm thinking of the right one, that one also has like this coconut and rum thing going on in there. But this one is a little bit on the sweeter side, but a different kind of sweet, because the Roja fragrance is a little more chocolatey from what I remember, but this one is absolutely amazing, fantastic. Nishane is such an amazing company as well. They have such a wide variety of really amazing fragrances, most of which kind of fly under the radar, but the ones that are being spoken about time and time again definitely deserve all of the praise that they're getting. And the next one is no exception, because this one is also by the company Nishane. And this one, completely different fragrance, different DNA, different perfumer. This one is by Cecile Zarokian and it's called Ani. Now this one came out more recently than Fan Your Flames, but this one is a vanilla dominant fragrance. So it has this really creamy vanilla in the opening. It has this fruity vibe to it as well. There's a little bit of ginger in here too. It's a really, really unique composition for gourmand lovers. If you are looking for a best-in-class vanilla, if you're a fan of vanilla-based fragrances and you want one that's just going to leave your head spinning and make you go crazy, Ani is among the best. So definitely check this out if you are a fan of gourmands. The next fragrance that I want to recommend is a little bit on the sweet side, but not too much. It has agarwood and it also has some spicy notes in here, one of which is saffron. And so this one by the company Inicio Parfum Privé is called Oud for Greatness. Now this one is dark, it's a little sweet. It has this undercurrent of vanilla, like a lot of the other fragrances that I mentioned. I think pretty much all of them have vanilla in them so far. But this one has this spicy oud, nagarmotha and saffron kind of a vibe. The saffron makes it smell a little bit leathery. I know people compare this one to Baccarat Rouge 540 by Maison Francis Kurkdjian, but if you're allowing yourself to fall so deep into the rabbit hole of accepting that comparison, I think you will really miss the magic of this fragrance. It does have a level of uniqueness to it, and it is a different scent. It's much darker. It's a really interesting composition, especially if you're looking for a gateway oud fragrance, and that's precisely the reason why I included it in this list, because so often people say, well, I'm not really into oud fragrances. What is an oud fragrance that you would recommend? And so I oftentimes point them in the direction of Oud for Greatness, and this one is just awesome. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is one that I purchased in the summer of 2020. I bought it with my own money. I love this fragrance so much, and it is one of my favorite summer fragrances. I actually reviewed it on a French channel a few years ago, so I initially smelled this fragrance a long, long time ago, but this one by the company Casa Morati, which is under the Zerzhov universe, is called Mephisto Gentiluomo. So this is a flanker of the original Mephisto, which I wasn't crazy about because it does smell quite similar to Creed's Silver Mountain Water. And as somebody that has Al Rahab Silver and also Silver Mountain Water, I didn't really need the original Mephisto. I felt like it was a redundant addition to my collection, but this one is amazing. It has this fruity and creamy citrusy quality about it that I just really love. And it's not overly ripe or citrusy or fleshy or juicy or anything like that, but this one has a really nice creaminess about it that I think makes it stand apart from other summertime types of fragrances that you might find on the niche market. And so Mephisto Gentiluomo is one of the best from the brand. I personally love this fragrance. Very classy, very gentlemanly. The next fragrance, and I have to apologize for doing this because this is the third fragrance on this list from the brand Nishane, but it just so happens that they have a lot of really amazing fragrances. And this is another one that I knew I had to get in time. And this one by Nishane is called Hachivat. And so this one is sentimental for me for a lot of reasons. One, there is a TV show or a kind of a cartoon after which this is based. It's like a shadow puppet theater. And this is a very famous shadow puppet theater that was also popular in Greece. And so it kind of reminds me of my grandfather. If you watch my review of it, I go into detail about that. But Hachivat is an amazing fragrance. And a lot of people consider it a close cousin of Creed's Aventus. And I can certainly sense that citrusy thing going on in the opening. But once you give it a chance to dry down, it's a little smoky. It has the birch. It is earthy. It has this patchouli quality about it too. It really carries forth this bad boy persona about it that I really, really like. And so Hachivat is an amazing fragrance, especially for somebody who says, you know, I like the Aventus style or the Aventus DNA, but I want to stand out because everybody is wearing Aventus and Aventus clones. I would definitely say, hey, as long as you don't mind your fragrance going in a little bit of a darker direction, definitely check out Hachivat. It's an amazing fragrance. The next one that I want to recommend is one of the original fragrances from this collection. And this has influenced so many brands, so many companies. And there are so many brands that are trying to put out their version of this particular DNA. But like I say, always go with the original, right? If you like that DNA, always go with the original. And this one is by Tom Ford. And this is Tuscan Leather. Yet another fragrance that I gladly purchased, and I will always be with a bottle in my collection. This is the original leather-based fragrance. Well, not really. I mean, there have been leather accords and fragrances for a very long time, but there's just something about Tuscan leather that I absolutely love. And it has that raspberry leather combination. It smells like you're sitting in the inside of a very luxurious car. You know, like a luxury car with a leather interior. It definitely conveys that vibe. And so, you know, I know you can go out there and buy Golden Boy by Duetto Parfum, which is becoming increasingly harder to find. There's Go Dolphin by Parfum de Marly. There are tons of fragrances that go in that Tuscan leather DNA, but this is definitely the original. And so I always recommend that people go for the original just so they have that accurate frame of reference. The next fragrance that I will never stop recommending is by Roger Parfum, and this one is called Elysium. So Elysium is unapologetically fresh. It has a ton of citrus in the opening, from lemon to bergamot to orange. There's juniper, you have this woodsy quality in the base as well. It's just very bright and energizing and invigorating, and it just smells like Roja quality. So it's incredibly high quality, one of my favorites of all time. And I have the Parfum Cologne version, and I also have the stronger concentration, which again, I purchased with my own money. But there's just something about this DNA that I really do love. I know people compare this to, you know, Creed Aventus or Dior Sauvage. I don't think it warrants a comparison. I think it's easy to say that it falls within the same family as those types of fragrances and it's appropriate for the same occasions and same scenarios, but it really is its own fragrance and it's one of my favorites. And the number one fragrance on this list goes to none other than Leighton by Parfum de Marly. Now this fragrance is so easy to recommend for me. It has the apple, the mandarin orange, the bergamot, the lavender, the geranium, the vanilla in the base. It is a complex fragrance. It's not as dark and daring as Leighton Exclusive, but at the same time, it does have this youthful masculinity about it. It's elegant, it's a little sweet without smelling like one of those bubblegum types of fragrances, like 1 million. And so it's a great fragrance. If you haven't tried it, you might have been living under a rock, or maybe you just can't find it in your region. Totally understandable, but please check it out. Leighton is probably one of the easiest fragrances to recommend from Parfum de Marly. And I think it's a really good gateway fragrance if you're just experiencing the brand for the first time and you want to see what they're all about and what they have to offer. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for tuning in. These have been top 10 fragrances that I will never stop recommending. part two. Once again, if you are interested in me doing a part three, or if you want to see a designer counterpart to this video, let me know, leave a comment down below. Also, if you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner, and while you're at it, make sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for watching. Love you all. We'll see you next time. Bye.